Welcome to another Tech Topics. My name is Wade. I'm an SRE in Durham, North Carolina. And today we're going to be covering the installation, configuration, and troubleshooting of the Nutanix SCOM Management Pack. We'll be using NOS versions 4031 with Management Pack version 1.3 and System Center Operations Manager version 2012 R2. Let's head right into a demo. All right, so to install the Nutanix Management Pack 1.3 or whatever the latest version is, you can go to portal.nutanix.com, click on Downloads, and then Tools and Firmware. Here you'll see SCOM Management Pack version 1.3. That will allow you to download the MSI installer. And there's also an installation guide right next to it. I already have it downloaded. We'll go through the installation. You just double-click the installer file and accept the EULA and hit Next through the installation. You'll want to do the complete install. And SCOM also has to be closed down while this is installing. Hit Launch Operations Manager Console and Finish. You'll see that there's some new sections under the monitoring. You'll have Nutanix and Nutanix hardware. And there'll also be new sections under authoring and administration. And we'll go through that in just a moment. But first, we have some prerequisites that we have to do inside of Prism. You'll click on the configuration wheel and then SNMP. And make sure SNMP is enabled. And then click New Transport. And the protocol will be UDP, which is default. And the port we're going to want to use is 161. This is actually noted in the installation guide as well. Hit Save, go to Users, click New User, and we're going to create a username here. This isn't a Prism username, this is just for SNMP traffic. So I'm just going to make it easy, SNMP user. And there's a couple different options here for priv type and auth type. You can use AES, DES, or MD5 or SHA. I'm going to use a default, but you need to make sure that you know which versions you're using because we'll need them later. Here you're going to give it a key, which is anything you would like it to be, and then hit save. We'll go back to SCOM, click on authoring, right-click on hardware cluster discovery, add monitoring wizard, and then click Nutanix Hardware Cluster Discovery and hit Next. Here you'll want to give the Nutanix cluster IP, which you can get by clicking the cluster name in the top left. If you don't have one set, you'll want to set it. Here ours is 10.63.4.204. And then hit Test. It'll prompt you for username and password. This is going to be your Prism username and password for the admin. And you'll see it actually pulled and grabbed the cluster name as well as a list of all the controller VMs. And you'll hit Next. And then you'll want to give it a name. This is a friendly name. I usually keep it the same, but you can make it anything you like. Use an existing management pack or create new. We'll create a new one, and we'll call it Nutanix Management Pack. After you've entered your name, hit Next, and then hit Create, and then Next again. And here you're going to associate a Run As account. And we'll have to create new accounts. Now, once you have them created, if you have a different cluster, you won't have to recreate these. Prism account is going to be what's used to log into Prism. The IPMI account is going to be what's used to actually log into the IPMI. These are just friendly names. So I'm going to call this Prism Admin so that I understand what it is later if I see it. The username, the password, IPMI, Same thing, give it a friendly name. I like to give it IPMIAdmin. And then you use your actual username and passwords that are used to log into the IPMI. And you hit validate, you'll see that they're both verified. Hit create, and it'll actually create those user accounts in the SCOM database. Hit next, and then create. So the Nutanix hardware discovery, actually what that's doing is you're giving it Prism credentials just so that it can pull what IPMIs are configured on the system and obtain their IPs dynamically so you don't have to enter it if it's a large cluster. So what we just did was configure the Nutanix hardware cluster discovery, and what that does is it goes to Prism just to obtain the IPMI IP addresses dynamically rather than have to have you enter them one by one. And then it will actually query the IPMI of each node to obtain hardware information such as fan speeds, system temperatures, power supply status, etc. Now, if we go to monitoring, we should be able to see that under Nutanix hardware. So after you've configured the hardware cluster discovery, it's a background process that'll take 5 to 10 minutes to complete before you'll see it on the monitoring page. And now we'll go to the software discovery portion. And what this will do is discover processes on each controller VM, as well as the configuration of each controller VM and everything that's Nutanix specific within the software side. You go under administration page, and then right click on management packs, and then discovery wizard. We're going to choose a network device, next, and we'll type in a friendly name. We'll call this Nutanix cluster. We'll choose the local server for administration. If you have more than one server, you can choose a different one. Explicit discovery. And here we'll have SNMP v1 and v2 run as accounts. We're not going to use that. We'll want v3, which is what the Nutanix cluster uses. Next page, we'll add a device, and you'll want to use the external IP of your cluster, and then choose SNMP version 3, and add an SNMP v3 user. Here's a friendly name. We'll call it SNMP user. And then under the credentials, we'll actually type in the username and choose the same authentication protocols and privacy protocols that we used in the configuration in Prism. Type in the key that we chose. And hit create. OK. Next, this section gives you the ability to schedule an automatic discovery of the Nutanix cluster in case your cluster expands or contracts. For this demo, we're just going to do the discovery manually and hit create. When the warning pops up, hit yes. And now we'll choose to run the network discovery rule when the wizard closes. So after the wizard closes, we can go to discovery rules under network management, and we should see discovery rule we just created. Let's just tell it to run. And this is a background process that'll take about 5 to 10 minutes to discover on the cluster. So after everything's been discovered, under the Nutanix cluster, that's gonna be everything from a software perspective. You'll be able to see the clusters, containers, controller VMs, storage pools, as well as performance metrics such as IOPS and latency. Under the hardware section, you'll actually be able to see the health of all of your SSDs, HDDs, your fans, your power supplies, as well as each node health and temperature. Now we'll go over some brief troubleshooting steps that we can do to make sure that SNMP is working properly. If you hit the configuration wheel in Prism and then SNMP, you'll see there's an option to download a MIB. If you click that, you'll see the MIB show up, and then you can save the page. This seems to work best in Chrome. I'll just save it to my desktop. And then you can use any SNMP browser. I have Manage Engine on here, which is an MIB browser. We'll choose to unload all of the MIBs that are currently loaded. and then load the Nutanix MIB from our desktop. Choose the MIB and then hit the configuration wheel. We'll choose SNMPv3 and then add a user. And we'll specify the target host to be our Nutanix cluster. Specify our username to be the same as we chose in Prism. Choose auth priv. And we are using MD5 AES. Specify the keys. Hit apply and OK and OK. And then you'll see inside of the MIB all the items that we typically discover through SNMP. We can choose any one of these and then choose operations, get bulk, and we'll be able to see all of the items that are returned through SNMP. Sometimes it takes a try or two for the discovery to work. If it doesn't work the first time, please run it again. Please check back for more videos, and thanks for watching. I hope this tutorial was helpful.